bumped into Farah Khan at Kapil Sharma's wedding, and my dad's introducing me to her, like, this is Jamie, my daughter, okay? She's like, isko to main thappadi marungi abhi, isko to. There's no nepotism. There is favoritism towards your friend's child.
Welcome to my Vala Lawson's kitchen. Yuck!
When are the restaurants gonna open?
I've had that one look where people have seen me upar se niche and said, थोड़ा बॉडी पे काम करना पड़े, अरे आपकी नोज की कटिंग करनी पड़ेगी, आप नोज बहुत बड़ा है. मैं ही क्यों इश्क जाहिर करूं, तू भी कभी बोल दे.
Hey guys, welcome to midday.com. Today I'm in conversation with the extremely talented Jamie Lever. Hi Jamie, how are you doing?
Hi Supriya, I'm really well. How are you?
Absolutely amazing, and talking to you even better. How's the lockdown been treating you?
It's been really good overall, you know. I mean, we've been safe, we are indoors. ठीक है, काम नहीं है, shows cancel हो गए, shootings cancel हो गई, लेकिन I think we had we've had a really nice time together as a family, had a lot of time to think about things, think about ourselves, what we're doing, how we're working, and how we can improve ourselves. So, बहुत ही I mean, we had good quality time to ourselves, lots of me time. So, you know, we got to think a lot, which is great. क्योंकि there is no time, you know, otherwise in Mumbai, life is so fast. कि वक्त नहीं मिलता कि, you know, to just stop. Take it all in to kind of like breathe, you know, to just see, okay, reflect ki acha, how did I do on my this job, or how what do I plan for the future, how do I plan out. So this was a really good time, you know, for all of us. Also, yeah, we got to know each other, what bothers us so much, what annoys the other person. So, aur kitna patience hai kisi mein, to ye sari cheeze we got to see, it was nice.
And we've also seen all the amazing posts that you've been putting up on social media. Yeah. Funny ones, the dance videos, the songs, everything. I mean, like...
Yeah, I mean, I got a lot of time to kind of experiment. You know, a lot of times when I was doing TV jobs, I was always asked to do something, and I was asked to do the same thing over and over again. Here, during the lockdown, it was like nobody's telling me to do anything, right? So I had the time for the first time in my life to just decide for myself, ki yaar, meko ye karna hai. No, I want to try out this dance. Chalo, let's just see kya feedback aata hai. Are people liking it, or what is the response? So I kind of, it was the first time I actually impersonated Nigella Lawson. And, you know, otherwise I wouldn't be able to do that on Indian television. Ya phir koi movie mein to ho nahi pata. So I was like, chalo yaar, let's try this. And it was, I'm just kind of like practicing my skill a little bit, and, you know, just kind of working on my craft. So I'm really enjoying myself. Also, for me to survive this period, to be, you know, happy and keep myself positive, I need to kind of do something. So I was, you know, I just went with it, started fooling around.
With Nigella's accent, I mean, you got the British accent on point.
If you're a comedian, you kind of like observe things and you see things differently. So when I was in London, I used to just, you know, just watch people. A lot of times I used to just be quiet, watch them talk, and you know how they are behaving. And you know, obviously I was from India, so mere liye to bahut hi, and I was by myself, right? So I was like, you know, what's going on? And I was like constantly looking. Guess karna hai ki ye Indian kabhi aaya hoga London mein, ya phir kabhi aaya hai. If you just see his face, you know, the person who's like staring at everyone like that, that is an Indian who's just come like ek hafte pehle ya 10 din pehle aaya hai London mein. Meri halat wo thi. I was new and I was just like, you know, taking it all in. Log kaise chalte hain, hi, so much. Kitni manners, oh, har cheez ke liye sorry, thank you, how are you doing? I'm good, are you fine? So I was just like, you know, taking it all in, and I very quickly picked up the accent also. So the accent was always, you know, it was there at the back of my mind.
Welcome to my Vala Lawson's kitchen. Yes, my Vela.
I don't know what got into me. I was like, yeah, Nigella, mujhe yaad aa rahi hai. Just started seeing her videos. Went with it, boom, made a video, and people are loving it.
Life is nothing without some chocolate. Lots and lots of chocolate. Oh, you just need some chocolate. Can you get some chocolate? All the chocolate.
Did you also mimic your teachers or your friends in school? And
actually, yeah, growing up, a lot of times I realized that I would come back home and, you know, just impersonate any teacher of mine. You know, I wouldn't tell my mom plainly, directly, ki, acha, teacher ne ye homework diya. You know, I'd be like, you know, mommy, that teacher said, Jenny, you have to give me, you have to, you know, there has to be pin drop silence in class. No one must talk. So I used to impersonate and create their entire scene, you know, when I used to come home. I used to tell my mom, ye aise bola teacher ne, and then she calls me jam bottle. And, you know, this teacher calls me that. And Lulu Miss said this and Annu Miss said this. I guess I used to do that a lot. But at that time, obviously, I did not know what I was doing. I was just being like any other kid, you know, I was just being a normal kid. But I think my parents were like picking up on all these things and they were like, kuch to hai.
I wanted to know from you, growing up in a home with Hindi cinema's most popular comedian, Johnny Lever, as your dad, how did that influence you?
Yeah, I mean, for like, not for like acting and stage. Why? Because I did not go for most of his shootings. I did not. Like 90% of his movies, I've not seen him. I never went for his stage shows. I don't know, my brother really liked going for the stage shows, but I never went. But I was really inspired by him, you know, by the conduct and the discipline and the kind of person he was at home, you know, such a perfectionist and so hardworking and so like dedicated to his craft. So that was like a very good influence on me. You know, those things I kind of picked up. He was very like punctual and he was very like proper with everything. Ye perfect hona chahiye, iska time aise hona chahiye, isko aise karo, usko aise. He's very like that, perfect. I remember when I was going for tuitions and my dad's very punctual, okay? He's super punctual. So I was going for tuitions and I said, daddy, if I go from here and I'll go in the lift, wahan mujhe 3 minute lag jayenge, and from the lift I'll go down and then I'll go to my teacher's house, it'll take me 7 minutes. And you know, I knew that he would be really impressed by that. So because, you know, he was like, okay, this is a good thing. She's picked up on that timekeeping wala thing. So those kind of things really impressed me. And I really admired all of those things. So that had like an impact on me. Right. Not really his work side.
Growing up, who was your favorite comedian? Apart from your dad, of course.
I loved Rowan Atkinson. We had like...
Mr. Bean. Like,
piles of so many tapes. We had just so many tapes because my dad, you know, what he used to do, he used to go for shoots all over the world. He used to go for shows all over the world. So he used to pick up tapes from there, videos, CDs and tapes. But he actually did not have the time to sit home and watch those tapes because he was working like a crazy person. So those tapes, you know, we used to steal from his cupboard. We used to play them and we used to enjoy ourselves. Yeah, I was really inspired by Michael Jackson and Mr. Bean and all these artists. We saw, started watching them at such a young age. We used to just watch Michael Jackson videos of him performing live on stage. So I really got inspired by these people, you know, more than my dad, because we do not see him go to work. And in fact, my mother created such a normal atmosphere at home, not intentionally, but only because she came from a very humble family in Andhra. So my mom ke liye it was like, meri beti badi hogi, ye toh doctor hi banegi. Mera beta bada hoga, ye toh engineer hi banega. And that was the atmosphere she created at home. Because she's like, nahi, nahi, South Indian hai, hum normal hai, hum idli dosa khate hai, bade hoke doctor bante hai, meri beti toh gynec banegi. So she kind of drilled it into my head. But somewhere in my subconscious, I was kind of taking all this, you know, inspiration from Mr. Bean and, you know, seeing how funny he is. Then Michael Jackson being a stage performer, and I was like so in awe. And I actually, for the longest time, I really did not know what my dad was really doing. We only would see his movies later, much later in the theaters. And, you know, and for me, it was like, okay, you know, this is his job. But I wasn't like wowed by it. I don't know how to explain. But very later, much later in my life, I realized how big of an artist he is. Like when people call him the king of comedy, what they really mean by it. Like, I think when I went to college, I realized, oh my, he's actually like the king of comedy.
Yeah.
Quite famous. He's a big deal. But until then, thanks to my mom, we were very like normal, like a very normal family.
How did your parents react when they found out that you wanted to become an actor?
I was in London. I was studying. But secretly, I was going for acting workshops in my university. I was secretly going for stand-up gigs and watching them. I was secretly watching a lot of shows at the West End. I was doing all of this secretly. And, you know, like I also got a job, you know, when I was in London after working. So job karte karte maine do plays bhi kiye through friends. And I had the chance to perform in London and perform with like white people and, you know, like in their groups, and I was the only Indian, and I was the only brown person. So it was just an amazing experience overall. I learned so much about myself. Until then, I was like, 22, 23. Until then, I did not have the confidence also to accept in my heart of hearts that this is what I want to do, because my dad's actually he's very conservative. He's very protective towards me, and he's been very like possessive. And also like, oh, ye ladki hai, nahi nahi, bahar nahi jana, late nahi hona, sleepover pe nahi jana. He's very protective of me. So I was very scared, about telling him, because I was like, he's never going to allow me. You know, he's very strict to allow a girl child to like get into this business, because he knows, what it takes. He knows how crazy it is, and he actually knows how difficult it is to survive. For the longest time, I kept ignoring, that feeling that you get inside of you, that mujhe ye karna hai. I was like, no. Main production kar lungi. No. Main direction kar lungi. But I was like, beating around the bush, when I knew I wanted to be the center of attention rather than just, being around it. My mom was the first one to know. I told my mom, I said, mummy, mujhe na stand-up karna hai, mujhe na comedy karni hai, main stand-up likhti rehti hun, I keep doing this, I want to do this. Again, she was scared for my life. She was like, this girl is mental. Like, what is she even talking about? If her dad comes to know, he's going to give her good. Like, he'll give her a piece of his mind and, he's going to get really upset. I guess if it's in your destiny, it all works out. My dad was in London for his tour. I sat him down and I said, Daddy, you have to admit something. I have to tell something. I have to tell you something really important. And then I said, I want to do comedy. And he just took a pause, took a minute. And then after that, he's like, okay, if this is what it is, this is what is written in your destiny, and if this is God's will for you, then I'm no one to stop you. And then, things kind of like, one thing led to another, and somehow, mera rasta banta gaya, and I came into the industry.
Recently, you also spoke about having body image issues and how you overcame that. What was it that motivated you to become what you are today?
I was very overweight at the time. I was like 80 kilos or more. I don't even know, because I never checked the weighing machine. I was like, yeah, no. Ay, nahi, nahi. So I was extremely overweight. I was obese, and for my height and everything, and it wasn't right. I was eating very unhealthy food, and I was like, because I was in London by myself, so I was like, are cake khao subah subah, muffin khalo, and I was just stuffing my face. So, and I didn't have my mom to even check on me. So when I came back to India, finally, after deciding that this is what I want to do, my mom was like, listen, you decide, you take a call. She's like, you want to be healthy, you want to stay fit, or you want to be in the category of that, like little overweight person who's overweight. And, there will be jokes about that. People are going to pick on that. People are going to say something about that. And you might even have to make jokes about yourself. So she's like, that is going to happen. And the audience will say something. So you decide. It's up to you. She's like, you either be here where people can see your talent and they don't talk about your body really. Or you be on that side where you have to kind of accept the fact that people are going to talk about your body, and also you have to be aware. Like, there is a Bharti Singh who, does the physical humor. She does it, she enjoys it, and it works for her. I mean, good for her. That's good. Right. She decided to go down that path. But I was like, nay, I don't want to take that route, because I'm very insecure. Like, if somebody will say something to me, it'll shatter me. So, I'll just start crying. So I was like, no, I'm not ready to do that. So I, fixed myself a little, in the sense that, I became healthy, started eating right, and I started feeling more confident. I was confident about wearing, when I was doing TV jobs, they expected, there were some roles where I had to wear like a skirt. Yeah. Jobi pants, Jobi. So I was comfortable then. I was like, this is good. It's working out. I'm not like body conscious, but yes, there are times where people do make you feel really bad for the skin you're in. Like, it doesn't matter. You're a star kid, or you're a celebrity kid, or you're nobody.
Right.
People in the industry, there are people in the industry. I've had that one look where people have seen me upar se niche and said, aapko workout to karna padega. Aapko to thoda body pe kaam karna padega. Are, aapke nose ki cutting karni padegi. Aapka nose bahut bada hai. Aapka ye theek nahi hai, ma'am. Ye teda hai na. So that happens. It happens. So you kind of have to deal with it.
Oh,
you have to find, mentally you have to be strong, where you have to know that, okay, these things don't affect me. and you just have to, you know, win people with your talent and not care about all of them.
So Jamie, you're really popular on social media, and I'm sure that you may be knowing about everything that's happening online, right from the debates to the discussions and the trends. And right now there's this huge debate on the insiders versus outsiders in Bollywood. Nepotism, of course, has been one of the most talked about topics since the past few years now. With you being Johnny Lever's daughter in this industry, what are your views on this?
I can just talk about my journey. Being someone who is, I'm an actor's child. I'm a star kid, as they say. I don't like saying this, but I'm a star kid. But for me, it's like, I think I realized that when people say nepotism is there, nepotism, okay? I don't feel like, you know, that applies to every star kid. It doesn't. One must not generalize and feel like all star kids have been given, you know, like are privileged, because I've had a very different journey. I feel like very strongly, I must say, Supriya, I feel like there is favoritism. There's no nepotism. There is favoritism to a certain lot. There is favoritism towards your friend's child. There's favoritism towards a group of people that you know and that you've seen growing up in front of you. There's favoritism, you know. And my dad has been the kind of person where he's like, you know, he's done his job like a job. He didn't make it his life. He went to work. He did his acting. He did his shoots. But he came back home and he lived his real life. You know, he lived his real life, which was his family, his people around him, his, you know, his spiritual life, his God and all of that. That was his real life. And he did not make his job the center of attention. And we were never a part of like any filmy parties. We never went. We never kind of like were in that gang because my dad was not filmy. My mom was a very, like I said, she came from a very humble background. So she was like, nahin, 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 mere bacche bas mere paas rahe, mujhe utna hi chahiye. She never left us one bit. My entire childhood, she was with us. She was like, you know, your dad is busy working, but I'll sacrifice my life, dedicated 100% to my kids. So she, you know, she was like very like that. So we never went to all of this. But when I decided to come into this, my dad never, never made any phone calls for me. My dad never said, meri beti aa rahi hai, please isko launch karna. Nahin, bilkul bhi nahi tha. I had to pick up the phone. I had to make calls. I had to go to comedy clubs and say, hey, can I audition? I'm an aspiring comedian. I've done it. I have picked up the phone and called casting directors, said, hey, you know, I'm Jamie and okay, you know, I'm Johnny G's daughter. Have to mention, can't run away from it because one day or the other, they're going to know about it. So I'm like, okay, but you know what? Can I come and test for you? Can I meet you? Can we have a meeting? I've done it. I've kind of had to create my own path. And my dad was very clear about it. You know, when I came down from London, he was like, haan, beta, tumko karna hai, kuch socha hai kya? Kaise karna hai? Kuch socha hai, koi planning hai? Then I was like, you know, like, okay, he wants me to do it myself because he also figured it out himself. He was a nobody, you know, being in Kalyanji Ananji's shows and then going on world tours. Wahan se nikal ke kuch unko koi ek film mein koi recommend karta hai and then he does a movie and then from one movie to another. So just that, in the same way, from me doing small stand-up gigs, then, you know, to going to a comedy circus audition, I've gone there, made that phone call and said, sir, I want to come and audition. On the basis of talent, I got my job. On the basis of that show, I got many other TV shows. On the basis of a couple of videos that went viral of mine, on the basis of that, I got my first film, Kis Kis Ko Pyar Karu. Then from there, I was doing a TV show where somebody spotted me and they were like, listen, why aren't you doing movies? And I'm like, sir, milti nahi hai movies. So from there, I got another movie. Then I got Houseful. And so kaam se kaam mila mujhe. Because we were never a part of any group. But I'm very proud of my journey, you know. I think I'm very proud of my journey. I've had this and I'm very proud of where I am today because today, if I'm getting comments like in my video, Instagram posts, I'm getting comments like, this is real talent. This is a true star kid. Then I've earned it. You know, I've earned that respect purely on the basis of talent and on the basis of, you know, how I went about things. True. So, ye hai outsider, insider ka bahut aajkal, I mean, bahut baatein ho rahi hain. I feel like we were, as a family, I'm just saying we were never like insiders. I mean, that's just how we are. My family. I don't want to talk about anybody else. All I can say is, you know, everybody deserves a chance. And I feel like, you know, this period, Supriya, has been very good for us as an audience because abhi kya hua hai? यू नो हमको आर्टिस्ट की परख हो गई है. वी नो व्हाट अ गुड आर्टिस्ट इज एंड व्हाट अ बैड आर्टिस्ट इज एंड हु इज वेल डिजर्विंग एंड हु इज नॉट डिजर्विंग. दिस व्हाटएवर्स हैपेंड नाउ विद अस लूजिंग अ वेरी गुड एक्टर, यू नो इट्स मेड अस क्वेश्चन थिंग्स, यू नो एंड वी आर क्वेश्चनिंग, डिड वी डू समथिंग रॉन्ग, आर वी सपोर्टिंग द राइट टैलेंट, is the producer supporting the right talent, are they getting the right opportunity, are the right people getting opportunities. So you know, we as an audience have had the time to reflect and think, maybe we're doing something wrong, maybe we need to go after true talent and not after, you know, what's been thopoed on our faces. They say nepotism, but I feel like there are a lot of things involved, there are many facets to it. There are agencies, there are PR groups, there are all these people who are shoving things in our faces constantly and saying isko pasand karo, ye lo. You know, there are a lot of things like that. But I feel like this is a very good time. This lockdown has been very good for us to sit and actually reflect and think, ki haan bhai, you know, what is true talent? What we should be after, in fact. Kisko hume follow karna chahiye? Kaun hume actually entertain kar raha hai? But everybody deserves a chance. And then audience is the judge. Right. The audience decides. Chahe wo koi bhi ho, hai na? चाहे उसका बैकग्राउंड कुछ भी हो या बैकग्राउंड ना भी हो, अल्टीमेटली द ऑडियंस डिसाइड्स एंड दिस इज अ गुड टाइम बिकॉज वी एज द ऑडियंस वी आर गेटिंग नाउ परख हो गई हमें बिकॉज वी क्वेश्चन्ड एवरीथिंग आफ्टर व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इन द रीसेंट टाइम्स. आई थिंक एवरीथिंग शुड बी इट्स ऑल पॉजिटिव, यू नो इट्स ऑल गुड, इट्स ऑल पॉजिटिव.
डू यू थिंक देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर फीमेल कॉमेडियंस आउट देयर इन बॉलीवुड टुडे?
I feel like I said, again, we are in a good space right now because, you know, I think back in the day when I started, it's been 8 years now. I started 8 years ago. And at that time, there were just next to nobody, like nothing. Mm. Just a couple very like, you know, you could just count them on the tip of your fingers. Very, very few female comedians. I think back then, maybe the society was such, but I feel like now we have changed a lot, you know, with time. There are a lot of female comedians out there. I mean, when I go for stand-up gigs, I go to watch a lot of stand-up gigs, and I see, like, I'm amazed to see so many female comedians up and coming, and I feel amazed, like, wow, this is so good. Like, back then it wasn't there. 8 years ago, nahi tha. You know, 8 years ago, I was... there were very few female artists, and when I remember when I went for my first gig at a comedy club in Mumbai, brand new comedy club in the whole of India, I think it was very the first one. When I went there and they told me, you know, they said, you know, we really need a female comedian, so I'm glad you came forward, and you know, also, you know, do this kind of comedy. They were telling me, you know, what kind of comedy I should do, because they're like, there are very, very few female comedians, so aise se karna, and you know, people will really enjoy to see a woman talk like that, be bold and be out there and, you know, talk like this. So, you know, there were really very, very few comedians then. I remember seeing Aditi Mittal at that time. She was also doing a lot of like open mics. So I was learning to do comedy. I was in Mumbai. But yeah, I saw Aditi Mittal doing open mics. And now see where she is. She's like one of the best comedians we have in our country. And yeah, so I think it's better, definitely better now. There are a lot of girls coming up.
And Jamie, I have to say, you are one multi-talented person. And anyone who's following you on social media certainly knows that. So guys, not only does she sing, she also plays the guitar. So for Midday's viewers, I would request you to play one song for us.
I've never sung this song ever, I mean, but I really like it.
सांसों में तेरी नजदीकियों का इत्र तो घोल दे मैं ही क्यों इश्क जाहिर करूं तू भी कभी बोल दे लेके जाने ही जाएगा मेरी खातिर है तेरा बहाना हुआ तुझसे ही शुरू तुझ पे ही खत्म मेरे प्यार का फसाना हुआ तू शम्मा है तो याद रखना मैं भी हूँ परवाना ओ जालिमा जो तेरे खातिर तड़पे पहले से ही क्या उसे तड़पाना ओ जालिमा
That was amazing.
Some notes went haywire, but I tried.
That was brilliant. Jamie, now we've come to the fun segment of our interview where I'm going to give you a situation and you have to react like the celebrity mentioned.
Done it 100 times, but it makes me so nervous.
Oh my God. Okay. So Sonam Kapoor reacts to the extended lockdown.
Oh God, yeah. Like, what are you all doing again? Now this has extended. I don't have clothes, Supriya. What am I going to do? No, I don't have clothes. Like, I've run out of all my designer clothes. Yeah, I need new clothes. If they're going to extend this, they should let me know so I can inform my stylist. Riyu or Riya, just arrange some clothes for me now, yaar. Yeah, you need to do something. Yeah, this is like ridiculous. Okay, yeah, okay. Thank you, yeah. You know what I mean?
Okay. Kangana Ranaut on wearing a mask.
Dekho, aise kya ho raha hai ki bahut sare log hain. मैं अभी आपको एक एक करके बताऊंगी मैंने लिख कर रखा है. बहुत सारे लोग हैं जो मास्क नहीं पहनते हैं, जैसे चुन्नू की मम्मी है, कल मैंने उनको देखा था बाजार जाते हुए, उन्होंने मास्क नहीं पहना था. और फिर मिसेस मंजू है उन्होंने भी मास्क नहीं पहना था. वो कल निकली थी और वो 3 किलोमीटर तक बाहर गई है, मैंने खुद उनको देखा है मेरे घर के बाहर से, ठीक है. वो 3 किलोमीटर तक बाहर गई और उन्होंने मास्क नहीं पहना है. और मिस्टर शर्मा भी है रोज हमारे बिल्डिंग में नीचे घूमते रहते हैं, लेकिन वो भी मास्क नहीं पहनते हैं. मैं कहती हूँ कि मैं एक एक से बदला लूंगी, मैं एक एक का पर्दाफाश करूंगी और मैं सबको सबक सिखाऊंगी कि मास्क पहने बिना बाहर नहीं जाना है. सबके पास सैनिटाइजर होना चाहिए, मास्क होना चाहिए. मेरा मास्क कहाँ है? खैर छोड़ो.
ऑलराइट, फराह खान ऑन फिटनेस एट होम.
So guys, you know what I've decided, that क्योंकि मेरा वजन इतना बढ़ गया है, ऑलरेडी पतला था और अब ज्यादा हो गया है, तो मैंने तो जूम क्लासेस शुरू कर दिया डांस के. तो आई एम टीचिंग एवरीबडी डांस ऑन जूम, या यू नो लाइक आई एम टीचिंग करीना एंड सैफ एंड सलमान एंड शाहरुख एंड एवरीबडी, बिकॉज दे आर वरिड दैट दे विल फॉरगेट देयर डांस. तो उनको मैं सिखाते सिखाते मेरा भी वजन कम हो जाएगा. दैट इज माई प्लान ऑफ एक्शन. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू बी फिट लाइक दैट. मैं नाचूंगी यार, आई जस्ट कीप डांसिंग.
एंड करीना ऑन कीपिंग तैमूर एंड सैफ एंटरटेन ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन.
माय गॉड, आई एम सो टायर्ड यार. मतलब कितना भाग भाग के तैमूर ने मुझे परेशान कर दिया. ओ गॉड, आई डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू. आई डोंट नो, आई थिंक आई गो आउट. ओ गॉड, बट अगर बाहर जाऊंगी तो मीडिया मुझे पकड़ लेगी. नो, आई स्टे होम. ओफो, सिकनी हूं मैं बजिंडा की और माँ हूं मैं तैमूर की. उफ.
आशा भोसले जी ऑन सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग.
देखो, मैं आप सबसे कहना चाहती हूँ, बहुत जरूरी है कि हम एक दूसरे से दूरी रखें. बहुत जरूरी है. और इस पे मुझे एक गाना याद आ रहा है, दो लाइन मैं गाना चाहूंगी. मिस्टर नायडू, बाहर मत जाना, कोरोना घर में न लाना. ओ मिस्टर नायडू, बाहर मत जाना, करोना को है हमें भगाना. डियर पप्लू, देखो तो लॉकडाउन का ये जादू. जादू 1 2 चा चा चा, लेट्स डू द चा चा चा, मी एंड यू चा चा चा, तुरु परपा परपा परपा.
That was amazing. And Johnny Lever on the COVID-19 precautions.
बाबा, ये क्या हो गया बाबा, हमें बचा लो बाबा, मेरे छोटे छोटे बच्चे बाबा, हम घर में बार बर्बाद हो जाएंगे बाबा, हमारा अब्बा जब्बा डब्बा हो रहा है बाबा, क्या करो बाबा.
श्रीदेवी जी ऑन द करंट सिचुएशन.
Oh, you know, I just have to say that बहुत जरूरी है कि हम घर पे रहें और follow what the government is saying. It's very important. Just my humble request. I feel like we have to listen to what the government is saying. You have to stay home and take care of yourself. And that is the only way ki hum fight kar sakte hain. So India, let's fight corona. Hi Shashi from India. Not I Shashi from the India, but I Shashi from India. Let's save India. Thank you.
Wow. Hema ji on the current situation.
नहीं, मैं क्या करूं, मैं कहां जाऊं, मैं परेशान हो गए हूं. मतलब मेरे धनु नहीं है और बसंती घन में बैठ बैठ के परेशान हो गए हैं. लेकिन हमें हमें घर पे रहना पड़ेगा, हम बाहर नहीं जा सकते. नहीं,
शहनाज गिल फ्रॉम बिग बॉस।
यार दोस्तों मतलब मैं क्या बताऊं यार, मैं परेशान हो गई हूँ। मैं घर में मतलब मैं बिग बॉस के घर से बाहर निकली हूँ, मैं घर में फिर से फंस गई। यार क्या हो रहा है यार, सिद्धार्थ भी नहीं है, मेरे फ्रेंड्स नहीं है, मैं किससे बात करूं, मैं दीवारों से बात कर रही हूँ यार। मैं मतलब मुझे बस बिग बॉस की एक बार आवाज सुननी है, बस बिग बॉस मेरी तारीफ करे, बस बिग बॉस मुझे ये कह दे कि शनाज तो बहुत अच्छी है, तो बहुत ब्यूटीफुल है, बस मुझे यही सुनना है और मुझे कुछ नहीं सुनना। बस बिग बॉस कहाँ हो यार, अभी बिग बॉस आप ही बात कर लो, कोई मुझसे बात नहीं कर रहा, मैं दीवारों से बात कर रही हूँ बिग बॉस, मैं पागल हो जाऊंगी।
And lastly, Nigella Lawson on the current situation.
I think that, you know, to deal with the situation, you just need a little bit of butter. And if you have a little bit of butter, it'll just make things better. You know, butter make things better. So just take a little bit of butter. And if that isn't enough, then I think you should have a little bit of chocolate, because chocolate is the best thing in the world. It just gives you a lot of joy. So just have a little bit of chocolate. It'll put, you might put on some kilos, but who cares? Just have some chocolate.
Oh my God, that was superb. I want to know also from you, Jamie, since your dad has worked with people like Anil Kapoor, and I'm sure Farah Khan and Sonam Kapoor also. So when you mimic them, has he ever got feedback about what you do, or you know?
I mimic so many people. I've you know, I've never had anyone say anything negative or like say anything bad, because I think they've all enjoyed it. And my intention, the way I do it also, is very like enjoyable. It's very like happy, positive. It's not like I'm making any personal attack, you know. And there have, my dad's in fact received phone calls from people saying, this girl is so good. Like Sunil Shetty is someone who's always calling my father and always telling him, ki Anna, this is like, look at this girl is doing so well. I came across her Asha Bhosle video. I came across this video. She's so funny. Then Anil Kapoor ji has actually called my dad and said, this girl is so good. Johnny, kamal hai yaar, Johnny. And then one time, in fact, recently, Javed Akhtar ji called my father and he said, जॉनी मुझे जैमी से बात करनी है, मुझे जैमी का नंबर दो। एंड यू नो माय डैड कॉल्ड मी, ही सेड जावेद अख्तर जी वांट्स टू टॉक टू यू, एंड आई सेड व्हाट, लाइक आई गॉट रियली स्कैर्ड, आई वाज लाइक ओह गॉड व्हाट हैव आई डन रॉन्ग, अब मुझे डांट देंगे या कुछ हो जाएगा, और यू नो लाइक आई डोंट नो मे बी माय डैड वांट्स मी टू टॉक टू हिम अबाउट समथिंग, बट ही took my number from my dad, specially called me, and I spoke to Javed ji and I spoke to Shabana ji both on loudspeaker, and they were praising me so much. And you know, they were like, Kangana ki jo tumne mimicry ki hai, ahaha, Kangana ki jo tumne mimicry ki hai, tumne Sonam ki jo mimicry ki hai, Jamie beta tumne to kamal kar diya, matlab duaye hai tumhare saath. And they were so happy. So he just feels proud. And yeah, but the only funny thing was, I remember I bumped into Farah Khan at Kapil Sharma's wedding. And I was like, hey, she's going to like, gala dabana hai ya kuch to hoga, kuch to crazy hone wala hai. But she was like standing right next to me. And my dad's introducing me to her like, well, this is Jamie, my daughter, okay. So Farah Khan is standing right next to me. She's like, isko to main thappadi marungi abhi, isko to... But you know, she said it in a very fun way. Like, I know, she's like, I hear about her all the time, you know, and people are constantly telling me, people in my building are telling me, have you seen Johnny Lever's daughter? Have you seen her? Have you seen her mimicry? Have you seen her mimicking you? So she's like, I constantly hear people talking about her. Isko to main thappadi marungi. Then there was Abhishek Bachchan, who actually retweeted one of my comedy videos, and he kind of like, he tagged Farah Khan saying, have you seen this?
I think
that kind of went viral. So a lot of people from the industry are calling my dad, in fact, wanting to talk to me, or wanting, you know, just wanting to say ki how good you know, they find me and how they really like my work. So just, I mean, he's just enjoying it. He feels, he's a proud father. He's very happy with the way things have happened for me, you know, like the way I people have received me and the love that I'm getting from people. Wherever we go, there's at least, in fact, wherever my dad travels, you know, he at least bumps into one person who will say, "Arey Johnny sir, aapki beti kamal hai, aapki beti ka to hum dekhte hain videos."
So he just feels very happy. In fact, even at work, when I bump into a lot of industry people, they are like, "Arey, we don't know what you're doing. You are so good. Dekha hai Asha ji ka. Arey, dekha hai. Humko pata hai."
Who's your favorite though? Like, whose voice do you love? You know, taking out and mimicking.
I have to just thank Asha ji for for her life, for being in, for existing. Had she not been there, I think I wouldn't have been here. You know, I think I'm here, I've reached here because of, you know, that one Asha ji impersonation. It kind of took me places. And no matter how much I experiment and no matter how many new things I try, you know, there is always that one person or at least somebody or the other will say, please Asha ji ki kar do. You know, and also that was such a new, fresh thing. Nobody had attempted it. So it was so fresh for someone to see a girl impersonating Asha ji, and also the voice was
voice also just, because the voice she's known for her voice, and you know, getting that right is like amazing.
So I, and also because I'm a trained singer, so singing aa hi jati hai, so I try to do, you know, like give it my 100%. But I feel like it's such a blessing that I have been, you know, blessed by this talent of mimicry. I feel like it's just a God's gift, because you know, wherever these celebrities can't go, I can go and I take their voice. And you know, whether we have them today or not with us, you know, they're, you know, I will be here and I will make sure that they are remembered, that people do not forget them, you know. Yeah. And there are people who really miss Shriji, and I miss her so much. And you know, whenever I impersonate her, they're like, you know, at least we can hear her voice and we can remember her. So I feel like I'm keeping, I'm happy that I, you know, it's a blessing that I get to keep these people alive and to take them to those places or to corners of the world where they cannot go. So I think mimicry should be celebrated and appreciated for that thing,
right?
You know, just for this thing that, you know, there are mimicry artists and there are artists who, you know, take, you know, mimic voices of great actors and, you know, who keep them alive.
Thank you so much, Jamie. That was so wonderful talking to you. Lastly, can you tell our viewers to keep watching midday.com in your favorite Asha ji's voice?
Dekho dosto, meri aap sabse guzarish hai, midday.com zarur dikhega. Isme bahut acche acche baatein hain aur bahut acche acche logo ka interview liya jata hai, jaise Jamie Lever ka interview liya hai. Dekhega, maze lijiyega, enjoy kijiyega. Ha ha.
Thank you so much, Jamie.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.